It comes to pass that the crows have too much class for port. The thunder cracked and the rain turned to hail as it threatened to get all biblical at Adelaide Oval today. And so it came to pass as the crows meted out punishment that may have included pestilence and a plague or two on the house of the power. Adelaide Oval was less Portress and more pile of rubble as a murder of crows, spearheaded by the genius that is Eddie Betts, dismantled their archest of arch rivals 18.22, 130, to 7.4, 46. Adelaide's 84-point win over Port Adelaide, a showdown record, beating the 2005 semi-final margin of 83 at Football Park, has all but locked away top spot and probably ended the Power's top four chances for good measure. The Power are now 2 games out of the 4 and can feel the Swans' hot breath on their necks. The Crows have no such worries, once again their no-fuss game stood up in the wet. Indeed, the Crows will be hoping the late winter rain extends well into September, and perhaps the first week of October, such was their ascendancy over Port. After a wasteful 1.9 opening quarter, they blew the game open in the second, partied in the third, and relaxed in the last. Rory Sloan shook off Travis Boak's tag, an unusual tag in that Boak ran off the back of the square to Sloan after each center bounce, to revel in the slippery conditions. Taylor Walker led from the front, and Richard Douglas continued his purple patch on the ball. Betts returned minus an appendix but with his extraordinary goal sense intact, slotting a check side in the second term and, look away now, Jason Dunstall, dribbling one home from the southwestern boundary in the third. Sam Jacobs, who won the showdown medal, beat Paddy Ryder in the ruck, the Crouch brothers racked up touches, and the all played well tag applied to the Crows' back six. Robbie Gray was Port's best by some margin. Boak laid tackle after tackle in trying to contain Sloan, and Tom Jonas battled hard deep in defense. But the magnitude of the loss exposed gaping holes in Port's 22, especially at the fringes. Angus Monfres had a miserable return to the side, Aaron Young, Jarman Umpey and Aidan Johnson struggled to find the ball and Sam Powell Pepper looked tired. Port don't appear to have the depth needed to go deep into the finals. And they certainly don't have the depth to cover for the injured Chad Wingard, but then again there is no covering for Wingard. The Crows dominated the first term but could manage only 1.9 to Port's 1.1. They should have had a 3-goal-plus lead at the first break. Betts and Walker both missed set shots from inside 40 meters late in the term to leave the door ajar for Port. A 1.9 scoreline was not a good look but the important numbers were running the Crows' way, especially the number 21, their lead in the column-headed contested possessions. The column-headed check side goals from the scoreboard mount pocket went from 0 to 1 soon after the resumption. Betts curled one through against the breeze from 40 meters out. The little genius does it so often it's almost routine. Port were only just holding up under the extreme pressure. Douglas was dominating the center, Sloan started to get on top of Boak and suddenly Port's defense was under siege. They flooded back to help their plucky but beleaguered defenders, but soon the dam broke. Walker booted two in as many minutes to open a 27-point break. The more Port pushed players back, the more free defenders the Crows had to mop up on the rare occasions the Power went forward, usually via Gray, who was handling the ball as if it were dry. Jake Lever, Rory Laird and Jake Cayley were having a field day across the center in a match that was being played in Port's back half. At the main break, the inside 50 count was 43-11, such was the Crows' dominance. The Crows had the edge in class. And they certainly won the contested possession battle, that count was out to 45 in their favor at the last break, which they went to with a 62-point lead. But the Crows were also winning the strategic battle. They were locking it in and there seemed no way out for the Power. Now there might now be no way into the Final Four.